1932 to 1945. On the outbreak of war, ladies and gentlemen, this is an open chapter that we can produce insufficient numbers to do agricultural work to eliminate the solenoid, start the tractor. This is a TVO version, and it's still used virtually every day on Mr. Webster's stable over at Elmstone Harding. But on the back is an earth scoop, and the tractor has got the scoop into the soil. You draw forward, you get like a wheelbarrow full of tulip of soil, and then lift it up with the three-point linkage, saving a lot of back-breaking work. Steve, you're here with the Seven Bell Club. Would you like to say a few words?
Yeah, thank you, Tom. The Seven Bell are always trying to attend this event.
And you've got the thrashing box here today, so ladies and gentlemen, you'll be able to see the thrashing box doing this today, so a reminder of the day prior to the combine harvester. Thank you, Steve. Well, a delightful chapter now, another chapter which contributed massively to the Second World War. The new Supermajor is here. And when the Supermajor was launched in 1960, it had its own promotional song. The Supermajor really was the Mark IV Major, and the main benefits of the original range was the advent of draft control on the hydraulics, give more disc brakes, and things like X-rated fittings to compressors, steam engines. But it was their president in the early 20th century, Colonel Fort, who decided to go for tractor production. And what a good idea it was, because Alex Chalmers became a major player, not only in America, but throughout the world with their tractor design. This is their first big success story, the high tide. These tractors had all sorts of innovations on them. Power steering is standard, oil and mass brakes are standard, and some of them had a power shift. And ladies and gentlemen, this mighty tractor will be soon sending out into Farmer Baird's playfield, and we'll be showing you what it's made of. And a 6-fire plow, ladies and gentlemen, that'll be a great sight. Of course, it picks up on the existing BMC Bell and Green Street. It must be remembered too, the BMC Mini Tractor was also available in petrol form as well as diesel. Thank you, Mr. Godfrey. Well, a tractor that's coming home this weekend, ladies and gentlemen. A Nuffield 425, and these were the second version of the BMC Mini, launched in 1968. And
27 horsepower. This is fitted with a ring, and a lot of these tractors are fitted with rings, so probably used for particular work, putting good three strokes that had a forest as well. Thank you for being my assistant. Thank you, Ben.
In a dilapidated state a few years ago, and restored it by the year 2000. And it's appeared on all sorts of road runs, charity events. It appeared at the Halloween Tractor Challenge. And it must be reminded that the Indian Classic Tractor Movement do a tremendous amount of these tractors to raise money for charities in all manner of ways. So long may that continue. And I believe this tractor's even taken part in weddings as well, hasn't it? Yeah, there you are. Anyway, okay. My time is running out, I think. Oh, did it? Sorry. Right, we're through these. Right, so I give value for money. Well, I'm not being paid anything, so, yeah. Anyway, keep the price down on a interesting tractor. The 4,500, 7,000, 1,400. Conversion.
So it was originally a traction engine. I see. I thought I haven't seen a Garrett steamer over, because there's quite a lot of 4-inch Garretts about the place. And a 4-inch for me is an ideal size for running on rally fields.